Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm Steph, I'm the Secret Slob, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm doing an extra special video with my very good friend and fellow YouTuber, Dianne in Denmark. If you've never heard me talk about her, you must be new here, but I will link to her channel up here, and she is going to do the same video as I'm doing today. So for October, we thought we'd get a little bit cozy. She's Danish, so we can say we're getting into the hygge spirit, and we're talking about our all-time favorite books. So I'm gonna first show you my favorite books from when I was a kid, and these are actually my personal books. So my first favorite book is Mog, the Forgetful Cat, and you can see here I've written my name in there. So I love this book. My dad is originally from England, and I'm pretty sure someone from there sent this to me when I was a kid. I love this book. It's just been my favorite, and I think he's kind of a classic character in England. I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong. My second favorite book from when I was a little kid is this book called Red is Best. I just love the little girl in this book. I think she just always reminded me of myself. She's super strong-willed and determined, and even though her mom probably knew what was best, she was pretty convinced that she knew what was best. So yeah, not a lot has changed. So my kids' favorite books, they're a little different than mine. They like those two, but their favorites, all-time favorites, are Roald Dahl books, like this one, The Enormous Crocodile, which takes about a half an hour to read, so we kind of hide this one, and this one called Dirty Beast. So again, Roald Dahl, this one is also mine from when I was a child. You can see it's been well loved, but yeah, they just think they're hilarious, and when the crocodile gets thrown, well, I won't tell you the end, but anyways, if you haven't checked out Roald Dahl books, again, British author, and they're amazing, and they're everything. So these are my kids' all-time favorite books. The last one I'll mention, favorite kid book in our house, is The Paper Bag Princess, written by fellow Canadian Robert Munch. And if you've never read this book, it's amazing. Girl power, this girl is smart, she is strong, and in the end, she doesn't get the man because he's just not good enough for her. So I love The Paper Bag Princess. We love all Robert Munch books. He's pretty much a classic and a staple in all Canadian homes. Okay, so let's get into grown-up books. So my all-time two favorite novels is The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Almost even more so is the second book in the series called The Restaurant at the End of the Universe. If you've read these books, I know you're probably cheering along with me because they are amazing. And I think they had a big impact on me when I was in my early 20s because they are so creative and so crazy and so wild and make you feel so small and yet so important at the same time. And even though it's a fiction book, I just felt like it had a really big impact on my life and really lets me see kind of the hilarity in the mundane and the everyday. So if you've never checked out Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, I highly recommend reading it. There is a movie, but definitely give it a read and try to get to the second one too if you can. The last category of books is nonfiction, and this is my all-time favorite type of book to read. I probably read 5 nonfiction books for every 1 fiction or novel, and usually the novels I'm only reading because my book club has suggested them, and that's why I'm in book club, to read more novels. Anyways, so these are a few of my all-time favorites. First of all, I could never not mention my favorite nonfiction author, Gretchen Rubin, and this book called Better Than Before. And if you are watching this channel right now, you have this book to thank for it, because after I read this book, Better Than Before, I identified myself as an obliger, which is a person who needs outward accountability to get things done and change their habits. So then I thought I could make a YouTube channel as my accountability to get my house cleaned, and thus The Secret Slob was born. So thank you, Gretchen Rubin, and this book, Better Than Before. If you are looking to make changes to your habits or just drop bad habits, I highly recommend checking this book out. It might open a few windows as to why maybe some of the things you're trying aren't working. So my all-time favorite book in my favorite genre, nonfiction, is called A Walk in the Woods by Bill Bryson. It's about a man, Bill Bryson, the author, and at the age of 45 decides that he is going to walk the Appalachian Trail. So the Appalachian Trail is an incredibly long, I think it's like 5,000 kilometer long trail through the eastern mountains, Appalachian Mountains in the United States, and it's intense, and a lot of people do it through a whole summer. So it's just following his journey doing that. And it was this book that has, you know, really guided and inspired my life to just try wacky and weird and crazy things, even if people think you're nuts It's all about the experience and what you get out of just trying and not feeling afraid or that you're too old to start something or that, you know, you're not good enough to start something, you don't have enough money to start something, just trying the things you want to do. So those are my favorite book picks. I wonder if any of them are the same as ones that you've chosen. I'm super interested to hear what my friend Diane has chosen as her favorite books. Please leave a comment with your favorite books and suggestions below. I know I love scrolling through and seeing your suggestions, and I know other people do as well. I'll make sure to put links in the description for all of the books that I've mentioned today, and I'm also going to put a link to my new blog post with all of the books that I'm going to attempt to read this fall. They're just kind of perfect little cozy up for fall when the weather's getting cold books. So again, thank you so much for joining me. Make sure you share your favorite books in the comments below and head over to Diane's channel and maybe get a few suggestions from her too. I'll talk to you very soon. Bye.